Leviathan here. So when you drive around in a supercar, you would expect that people would be genuinely interested to find out more about the car and what it's like to drive and experience. Wrong. What you actually get is a pretty offensive investigation into your life. After 3 years of driving a supercar and confirming this with other supercar drivers, these are the three most ridiculous questions that non-motorheads tend to ask. Starting with number three, how much did your car cost? And I'll be honest, there is no correct way to answer this question, because either it's going to open up the doors to more questions, or you will get a lecture to stress how you are a horrible person for driving such an expensive car when there are people out there in the world suffering. And you will get priceless advice to sell your car, your home, your clothes, even this $5 bracelet that my sister got me. After they are done enlightening you, they will carry on with their lives feeling good that they did their part to make society a better place. Number two, did you buy it or did you lease it? The correct answer, you rented it. Why? Because some people think that when you drive around in a supercar, you're making a personal attack against them, as if you drew the first blood, and it's up to them to put you in your place, either by shouting something offensive or even throwing objects at you. And believe it or not, I've actually been there. So the best way to really disarm these people is just to say that you've rented the car, because it really shuts down any other questions, because you know you're not going to get any insightful conversation out of it, and it's just the best way to disarm them. And finally, question number one, what do you do for a living? This is the question on everyone's mind, and sometimes they'll just bypass question three and two and jump straight into this one. But I'll tell you the truth, the answer is irrelevant. Let me give you a few examples. Do you think you could get big like Arnold Schwarzenegger if you just text and take selfies while you're at the gym? Or do you think you'll be a professional musician if you just play the notes off of the C major scale? Or do you think you could be the next greatest app developer just by knowing how to code? No, no, and no. But you really have to be passionate and determined regardless of what it is you do. Look, in the end of the day, people are just expecting an easy answer. Something like, oh, I invested it and got lucky. Let's take the car totally out of context. Would you ever approach random people on the street, ask them how much their sunglasses cost or what they do for a living? No, it's just pretty embarrassing and petty behavior if you ask me. And the reason people ask these questions is not because they want to change your lives or get some sort of insight. They only do this to try and feel better about themselves at your expense. And it really surprises me that people actually have the audacity to ask these questions to random strangers while they're driving. Not once have I ever been asked what this car is like to drive. And that's also why I have a YouTube channel, to share exactly what these cars mean to me. And it's not a matter of demonstrating social status, but really experiencing and enjoying these cars. And that's, to me, what this is about. Well, I'll be honest, it's a bit fun to piss some people off. That's not why we get these cars. So that's it for me, guys. Thanks for watching.